Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, and now we will honk. How long are we waiting?
Oh! Hey, you're V, yes?
Hi?
Oh, fuck. Yeah.
You have a grenade in
you
your
didn't
head?
Answer my question.
There's something on your face there.
There's something on your face?
The grenade.
Can I ask why? You have a juggling accident?
Not cool. You ask personal questions and yet you haven't even introduced yourself. You are V, correct?
Who the hell else would it be? Yeah, that's me.
Yeah, that's me.
Good. Then let's go.
Where to?
Little China. I have a craving for Kung Pao chicken. Extra spicy.
Oh. Do you know? Drive Ozob to Little China. Can I get out and grab this thing, Ozob?
You go fucking bananas? Get behind the wheel!
Hold your horses.
No funny business. Get back in.
I guess we might fail the quest if I stayed out of the vehicle too long.
Come on, we gotta hurry.
Alright. Little China, here we come. Frame rate in the 20s.
What?
The grenade. You know, the one in your face?
You get used to it. I just gotta be careful not to pull the pin when I want to pick my nose.
What? Am I going in here? Yeah. In a roundabout way, it was telling us to go in here.
Nice out here. A lot of stuff has changed.
Where are you from?
Changed from what?
Brazil. You know, down in South...
I know where Brazil is.
You never know with you gringos.
Let's turn together.
Save oh. me!
This thing is very hard to control. Good God. What'd she say? Save me?
Heard of them?
Who hasn't?
Got any friends in there?
No, why?
Just asking. Can't help being curious.
Yeah, you gotta stop talking to me. You're distracting me. Am I supposed to... Wait. I'm supposed to take this?
Damn it! I need more time!
I can't keep this thing going in a straight line. And the frame rate's not helping. 22 frames a second right now.
What's your problem?
I can't... I'm drunk, okay? Got all the samurai greatest hits playing over here.
This is the place. Wait for me here and keep the engine running.
We came all this way to get takeout?
You could say that.
Somehow I don't think he's just getting food. Who's that over there? The baddies. I don't want to wait in the car. I'm the getaway driver here. Right, he went back there. What happened? I got out. I did not.
What the fuck was that? You got grenades up your ass too?
I didn't get out myself, if that makes any sense.
No! No!
Yes.
Want a taste of this, assholes? You see what I did to him?
Yeah, with my help.
Ha! Not bad, right?
Would have been even better if you'd told me what you were planning from the get-go.
It's true what they say. You're good. Really fucking good. Got a stick up your ass, though. This is where we part ways. Good luck, V. And, relax a bit. Okay?
That's it? Wait, you never told me how you got the grenade in your face.
Now are you gonna tell me about the grenade?
It was like a clown.
That. My brother ripped it off during a fight.
Just saw the hair.
With pliers.
Unhappy family.
You don't know the half of it. I could have chipped another one, but I don't know. I think this matches my style more.
Uh-huh.
Besides, it's a real icebreaker with the ladies. Got any powder for my nose?
And does it work?
Not really.
Yeah, not surprised. What about my payment?
What about my payment?
What about it? Here, like I said before, the best don't come cheap.
Thank you.
Take care, V. And hey, keep your nose to the ground.
Yeah. Well, that was a quick one. I guess we'll head on to Judy's apartment then. You ever hear the saying, no good deed goes unpunished? You hold your hand out to someone, you get bitten. You help a poor soul in need, you get fleeced for all you're worth. Save someone's life? Fill in the blank. I'm surprised they made that. That's part of the music. I thought it was a noise from behind me. Oh. It doesn't take the turns very well.
So people, listen up, this is serious. I want
we took the wrong way?
You know the name Raven. You know more Dinalar. And of course, Kuroshi.
Well, you're freaking me out here. You keep changing me back and forth.
Probably you've got at least one of them in your skull right now, don't you? But do you ever wonder who's watching behind those
eyes? You already heard this, Mike.
I think it's time you do. Because those eyes aren't yours, you know. Somebody makes them, somebody programs them. Those moments you think are private? How can you be so sure no one's watching? The next time you're out doing
you're having us make a U-turn up here?
Maybe when you pull the trigger on that job, the corporate manufactured your eyes as evidence. You think you aren't a target for blackmail? You better think hard.
I could have just turned anywhere.
But be honest with yourself. Where do you think they get the data sets for the newest brain dances? Probably your private life.
Okay.
But hey, don't limit your imagination, because the corporations sure don't. What if there's stuff
back on track
they don't want you to see? Chameleon filter there, some perception coding here, and suddenly they can decide what you even get to see. Who knows what they might want to hide from you?
Oh, oops.
Spies,
hey,
secret
wait.
Labs, facilities, and of course, that kick murder squad they sent to your door because you knew too much.
What so bumper came off? Are you still there? Move.
Not with these synthetic eyes.
I haven't seen Judy for a long time. I do not like driving this thing. I like the novelty of it, but it doesn't handle, like, well at all. Well, we're just about here. I think we're gonna abandon this car. Don't rub you. What about hit you? Can I hit you instead? How you doing?
We got a problem?
Not as far as you know. I'm sure I've already looked around this place. Oh, I gotta...
Burdoffs herself to express her undying gratitude to you for saving her ass.
Shut up.
Stop talking. I was only gone an hour.
The hell happened? How did this happen?
How did this happen?
I don't know. I told you. Evie was lying in bed like always when I went out. And I got back to...
Fuck.
If I'd just known, I'd have...
Checked her pulse, I imagine.
You checked your pulse?
She's gone.
You can't blame yourself for this.
Don't blame yourself. Won't solve anything.
I should have sensed something. That it was off.
Stop. Couldn't watch her 24/7. She'd made up her mind. Would have found a way. Always.
Well, didn't I ask this already? How this happened?
How did this happen?
I don't know. I told you.
Yeah.
Evie was lying in bed like always when I went out. And I got back to...
Fuck.
If I'd just known, I'd have...
Well, we gotta do something. Bury her?
Gotta do something with her.
Don't want any trouble. I'm calling the badges.
Sure.
Can you carry her to the bed?
Yeah.
As if that'll change anything.
She's dead. I don't think it hurts to move her. It's not like we can do anything worse to her.
I need to report an accidental death. North side, Jackson Street.
No. No imminent danger. Suicide.
Tomorrow. No! Today!
What the hell was that?
What part of dead don't you understand?
No, she was not pronounced dead by trauma team. If she'd have had coverage, we wouldn't be talking. And fuck you! If you don't want to move your asses, why don't I come down to the precinct and trash it into bits? Now will you come and arrest me, you pussies? Fine, I don't give a fuck what you write me up for.
They'll be here soon.
Told me to keep her on ice until tomorrow. Can you believe the balls?
Literally on ice? Huh. You went easy on them anyway.
All things considered, you let them off pretty light. Had it been me, they'd have gotten an earful like nobody's business.
What's this news report?
Put something on her. I'd rather she look like a person than a body.
Oh, wait. News report 7/17/2062. Oh. Let's just read this really quickly before I forget. A fatal incident occurred on Friday in Laguna Bend, a town located in the area surrounding Night City. Residents refused to vacate their homes, properties which had been officially declared a construction zone by the corporation which had purchased the land. Despite not all homes having been evacuated, construction workers are ordered to begin their work to prevent further financial losses due to delays. One resident climbed a crane in order to stall construction. The crane operator responded by lobbing objects found in his control room at the man. The operator subsequently lost control of the suspended load, which collided into a home and killed a family who was still inside. Damn. The conflict between Night City Dam Limited and the residents is not new, but until now has not led to any casualties. The dispute began a few months ago when rent prices in Laguna Bend rose drastically, after which residents were informed that the land on which their houses stood was to become a reservoir. Some of the residents relocated to temporary housing that was built as compensation. However, those who ignored municipal directives and stayed put became the victims of a corporate smear campaign which identified them as Agents of Public Unrest, APUs, who were preventing necessary construction in order to secure access to clean water for all of Night City. As a result, public opinion quickly turned against residents of Laguna Bend, and few, if any, paid attention to the change in police tactics and open violence against the residents. One could say it was only a matter of time before incidents like the one on Friday would occur. Oh, this is delightfully random. In celebration of the Grand Imperial Mall's grand opening, we're offering 30% off everything in-house. Today only, use code WELCOME30GIM to claim your savings now. Hundreds of offers on thousands of products. Can't decide what to buy? Talk with one of our expert sales advisors. Can't carry another bag more? Catch a movie at the cinema. Feeling worn out? Don't leave just yet. Napping pads are available on demand. I don't want these people to ever leave this place. And don't forget, every purchase you make enters your home into a lottery for free tickets to the Ferris wheel and roller coaster. You don't want to miss the best view of the Night City skyline in town. Oh. This isn't long, though. Silverhand, the creator and destroyer of samurai. Hidden somewhere between the Arasaka propaganda and Silverhand's own self-curated image, there exists a real story behind the frontman of samurai. The fact of the matter is, no one truly cared to find it. Labels, legends, slogans to chant, that's all everyone wanted from him. But by digging meticulously into all the dirty details of his life, all of the inconsistencies and exaggerations come to light. One of the biggest gaps in Silverhand's life was the period he spent with nomad communities. Hidden from civilization, Johnny could have acted like himself or removed the mask he wears in public. If the world could get testimonies from the people who had contact with Johnny during this period, not only would every biographer, I guess, be grateful, but more importantly, experts might have a real chance to offer a clinical diagnosis for one of the rock scene's most iconic personalities. Looks like all the new stuff gets put to the top, so... Oh, Earth Reborn. Our world is a world of people. Mankind has effectively eradicated any supernatural beings, mythical beings, folkloric creatures... I didn't know that was a word. Folkloric? Folkloric creatures, gods, even the monotheistic god. Mankind has even given up hope of contact with extraterrestrial civilizations, though little green men have been among us for some time already, paying us visits in their flying saucers. Only man remains, and man looked around and realized he was alone. In his loneliness, man felt the emptiness within him and started to repopulate it with beings other than himself. That is how artificial intelligence was created, from simple, deterministic robots obedient to their human masters to becoming more intelligent and independent than man could ever conceive. The unpredictability and power of artificial intelligence was greeted by man with apprehension, but also with joy. Finally, spirits and elemental forces have once again returned to our world. We could catalog them, construct a hierarchy, we could fence them off behind the black wall and draw a new line between what is natural and supernatural. Here is the earth and here is the sky. How painful man's solitude must have been if he had to create a palpable technological mythology and surrender to the demons of his own creation. Alright. Caught up.
Could you wait outside?
Oh. Well, can you imagine this is when I'm reading this?
Close the
door, V. Okay.
Please.
You just imagine that's when I'm reading all the stuff. Makes sense, more sense else while I'm waiting.
Bum a cig.
I can't get up.
Didn't know you smoked.
Quit. It's been years. But right now I need something besides air in my lungs. Please, V, just one.
Oh, fine, here. I guess I only have them because Johnny makes me buy them.
Fine, here.
That was her smoke case.
You sound different. Do you want it back?
Wanna hold on to it? No. You seem to like it. Keep it.
I don't like
kinda
smoking.
Kinda glad it's you that has it, actually.
She sounds so different. That's a big cigarette. Good God. Either that or she has really tiny hands. Yeah, it's like a blunt or something.
Fuck, Evie. I let her down. I thought if I gave her some space or time, she'd get back on her feet.
I don't think she let her down. I can't say that. Stay strong, Judy.
Stay strong, Judy. Don't let this tear you down.
Know what? Let's just not say anything for a minute, okay?
Okay.
Remember Fingers? How he said Evie was with him for 4 days?
Uh-huh. Did say so.
She disappeared from Clouds a week before you turned up. Tom told me later. Couldn't sleep at night knowing that. Kept thinking, what the hell happened to those other 3 days? So I did some more digging in her virtues. Found Woodman. He kept her. Had his way with her.
I killed him.
The things he did. And once he got bored, he pawned her off.
What did Woodman do?
What did Woodman do to her? Did you see it?
Yeah. And I really wish I could unsee it.
So you found other recordings?
Wait, so you found other recordings?
Had another look at the corrupted ones. You know, lots of static. Hard to pick up anything, really. At some point, I stumbled on something like an echo of the spat we'd had. Last time we saw each other. But I know she wasn't scrolling.
Why was it saved as a virtue?
Got no explanation for it.
They hacked in and recorded
it. Maybe she recalled it later, relived it, almost. Implant could have been on when, you know, as a defense mechanism, escaping into the past so as not to live in the present.
I had no idea Woodman was such a monster.
I had no idea that guy was such a monster. Saw him as your average tricksy sleazebag.
Glad I killed him.
He puts on a convincing facade. I knew him, but I never thought him that sick in the brain. Gotta be something I can do about it.
Like what?
Don't know yet. Think I'll call Suze. Thanks, V. Sorry, but I'd rather be alone now. Promise to keep in touch.
You sure you don't need anything?
Sure you don't need anything? No, but sweet of you to ask.
Alright, if anything comes up, just call.
Anything comes up, holler on the hollow. That's it, huh? Okay. He crashed. And now it's not here. Okay. Bot Moss Collective. Wake up and wake others up. Join our collective. Job. Investigate the site from the Bart Morris Collective message. Okay. There's all kinds of stuff popping up near. Yeah, let's do that. I thought that was my vehicle, that one. Yeah, it didn't make the dramatic entrance though, so I wasn't completely convinced. Well, this thing's not handling any better either. Maybe it's I'm just not used to it. Any more practice? I'll let you go. Why just stop there? The hell? I don't know if she was laughing or crying. Or both. Stealing. There's no reason for you to be stopped. It says slow. It doesn't say stop. Well, I guess there is a light there. This side? Good, because that always screws me up. Three quests and one. Episode? Odie Doll.
This is Jillian Jordan with an N54 news campaign update. Exit polls for the Night City mayoral race have finally been tallied. Incumbent Weldon Holt of the Devolutionist Party received 47.8% of the vote, despite allegations of his complicity in the murder of Lucius Rhine, former mayor of Night City.
Yeah, people don't care. Just kill everyone. We'll vote for you anyway.
Still seized the election with 49.3%.
Oh, he did? He got the election?
In his concession speech. speech, Mayor Holt offered his congratulations to the victor.
Oh, wow.
Now we see whether Perales will be able to realize his ambitious campaign promises.
Really?
After the break, when will the Corsairs end their losing streak?
Now, if only they could stop people from spying on them. Is the site my apartment or something? Oh, I'm supposed to go on here to do it? Bartmoss Collective. Reward for any info on Swedenborg. Best Isis. I'll pay for any info about Swedenborg. Riviera's true identity. I'll click read more on this, some of this stuff. Corporate oppression will end when you stop oppressing yourself. This is one of Swedenborg Rivera's most poetic aphorisms. He shows us that in reality, we are the drivers of our own actions. If workers unite, the towers of capitalistic oppression will fall. We must do everything in our power to achieve that. Energix Admin. A comment by Carl Forever. When corporate tyranny ends, the worker will no longer be dehumanized. Comment by Professor Socrates. Energix Admin, I implore you. The anti-capitalist discord of Swedenborg Riviera is much more complicated than it seems. He is undoubtedly here referring to an existential crisis weaving together threads from Heidegger and Jaspers. Reading both of them may provide you with critical insights. Comment by Jory. Lesson 3. I have this quotation. Brings tears to my eyes every time I read it. Comment by LOL3077. Don't crap yourselves. Think it too hard, book nerds. How do I go back? I gotta go like that? Okay. Humanity is nothing more than a Ponzi scheme hidden behind a veil of tears. Every person is a bearer of suffering, as well as its catalyzer and transmitter. In our global free market society, such an obstacle cannot merely be transcended. The first step is realizing that our decisions are illusory. New life, new pants. Comment by Sweet Kinney. Socialize the means of production, replace corporations with collectives, throw in a bit of rationally oriented management, and this whole global pyramid scheme will collapse on itself. Comment by Rebel underscore 777. I can't wait for the Communo-Eco-Cyber Revolution, led by Swedenborg. Comment by SR underscore... These people like underscores. Rules. Do you really have interpret everything through a neo-Marxist lens? You wouldn't notice Schopenhauer if Swedenborg smacked you on the head with the world as will and representation. Asinus asinorum in sacula sac... Okay, then. Comment by I Am Abyss. You can stick Schopenhauer up your pretty little butthole. I like that comment the most. The Way. I didn't see that. I think I saw all this except for The Way. The best weapon against neoliberalism is uninterrupted meditation. Does this even warrant an explanation? Meditation here is a metaphor for worker unity. Fear of a corrupt government controlled by tyrannical megacorporations has led to a mutated strain of pathological hyponeoliberalism. We can't let them bully us into fear. It's time we threw off our corporate yoke. Comment by Adored. Dismantling the mechanisms of capital accumulation or hypercapitalism? Do we really need to fight neoliberalism? I am not an evolutionist, but I believe humanity should go forward, not backward. Progress is a benefit in and of itself. Comment by Mimi Cute Girl. Once I meditated, then I woke up. Comment by Random underscore no name. The coherency is Swedenborg's philosophy is irrefutable. How has he not already sparked a revolution? What is Arasaka or Militech in the face of united opposition? Comment by Dixie Must Die. In my view, it's an elaboration on the philosophy of peaceful struggle. The word meditation should not be taken literally. The path, perseverance, and humility is not easy, but bears the sweetest fruit. When money exchanges hands, your true self becomes a victim to capitalism. Truth is hidden in simplicity. Every transaction, every transfer of funds is linked to the progressive assimilation of the individual into the machine of capital. Swedenborg Riviera understands that such moments disrupt the human being's ontological balance if it is not subjected to a symbolic annihilation of being altogether. Excuse me, being altogether. Comment by Where's Our Knight? Why does everyone hate on neocapitalism so much? Whatever your stance on them, corporations are long-term institutions that guarantee the stability of the social order. In fact, it's capitalism that has liberated the worker to be free to shape their own destiny. How is that bad? Oh, here's Dixie Must Die again. LOL. Guarantee. I did see that. Go buy a dictionary. I just thought it was another typo, like we've seen so many in this game. Professor Socrates, the truth is we're being ruled by a neo-bourgeois class. They are the ones who possess capital and the means of production. Class divisions are even deeper than they were at the beginning of the 20th century, but nobody ever talks about that. SR Rules says Swedenborg for Perez. Okay, reward for any info on Swedenborg. I'll pay for any info about Swedenborg Riviera's true identity. Investigate. Call Bess Isis about Swedenborg. My name is Bess Isis, and I'm an independent journalist. I ended up here after the recent incident at Helvetia you might have heard about. Who exactly is the man that inspired the attacker? The man shot you all? The man that you all practically worship? Have you ever wondered who Swedenborg Riviera actually is? I know I have. So here's the deal. I'm willing to pay for any info that might help unravel this mystery. Don't hesitate to get in touch. Bess Isis. Comment by SR Rules. Nice try. You think we'd betray our leader to a corpo slut like you? Even if I knew something, I wouldn't tell you crap. Do not help this woman. Corps want to silence our leader. Comment by Rococo. To SR Rules. LOL. First you call her a corpo slut and then you use woman? Real gentleman right here. What's wrong with saying woman, though? Comment by Wallenrod underscore 44. I heard that Swedenborg was a high-ranking corpo and he dismantled the system from within. But then they found him out and now he's shacked up somewhere on Mosquito Coast in Nicaragua. Comment by Interjects Admin. Congratulations, you've all managed to break about half the forum rules. I'd be lying if I said I was sad to close this thread. Admin. Alright, so we gotta call that, but I do want to see what this is. The way. You are here, for all I know, I've read this and just forgot. You are here, therefore you think. You think, therefore you have money. You have money, so you know that a child is a high-risk investment, but not with us. With our patented educational system, The Way, you can sleep easy knowing your child become a proper corporate individual. Nice. We could provide an outline of our teaching methods, but trust us, you don't want to know. So enough chit-chat, let's get down to brass tacks. You want your child to be an achiever? Send him to us. We'll drill knowledge even through the thickest skull. You pay, we provide confidence. I wouldn't trust us in my kid there. Still browsing? What are you waiting for? Our learning center. Date established 24/7. Students 9,348. That's a lot. 1 to 19 teacher to student ratio. Director, Dr. Jason Stone. We create leaders. Student testimonials. I chose The Way because I wanted to be among the best. Besides, Night City is beautiful. It's so rich in feeling and possibilities. Martha, Oregon. Do you want people to envy you? Join The Way like I did. There's a rush every time you have school and everyone is staring at you. Eric, Texas. Look, before I came here, I didn't know what a pyramid scheme was. Now I do. It's awesome. Teachers here are like super dope. Cecil Adams, Montana. The Way, medical care. Good medical care means private medical care. Everyone knows it, but not everyone can afford it. What's up with that, you ask? The only thing we can do is pat you on the back and say, no reason. That's just Night City for you. If you want to be healthy, you have to pay. We have money, we have the best specialists. What's there to think about? Pay now. We provide private medical care for you and your loved ones. We take the balance between your child's knowledge and appearance very seriously. Thanks to the Dorian Gray program, we ensure your child's aesthetic as well as intellectual development. Don't wait for beauty. Enroll your child today. Spelled wrong. Now you can pay in installments. Spelled wrong also. We conduct operations in our very own surgical clinics. Your child can be smart and beautiful. Schedule a free consultation with a teacher who will assess your child's intellectual capabilities now. We're licensed to conduct cognitive enhancing procedures on your child. In other words, they'll stop being idiots. Wonderful. Yeah, don't ever do that. Alright. We're gonna call her, but that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.